No. This is, Balan from, Balan Wonderland. I played the demo, I guess, but, yeah, I didn't really play the game, and, I don't know, something about the designs. Yeah, the guy with the hat. Something about the design is me thinking. I'm in, like, a project that's, like, reanimating the opening to the game, so I'm just kind of been thinking about the design. And, you don't want me to smudge? You don't want me to smudge it? I don't care, it's a sketch. I'm gonna ink it, so it doesn't matter if I smudge it. No, it's just what my fingernails look like. If you care so much about smudging, you have the incorrect priorities. That's all I'm saying. What kind of shoes does this guy got? Okay. They're like... Okay. Thank you. I mean, tons of stuff. It's been a long time since you've been in that server, so I mean, it's just like a million different things. Nothing major, I guess. Drawn art, sharing stuff we find online. I don't know, he seems to be fine. I mean, you wouldn't really want to ask me about that. I don't really have a ton of time to spend on Discord lately, so I don't really know. Man, I don't know what you're talking about. That's y'all's issue. You guys can go have your drama. I'm not interested in any level of whatever you're talking about. Yeah, whatever. Excuse me. Okay, I think Vinny needs a timeout. Jesus, dude, take a hint. I don't want to talk about any of that. I could probably be making this a little more dynamic. No, this soundtrack is from Cuphead. It's the Cuphead soundtrack. I have it on CD, so figured it's a video game, so it's less likely to get, you know, copyright claimed while it's on Twitch, at least. And yeah, just chill out, man. I'm not here to do any weird roleplay stuff, alright? Same with On My Server, man. Just chill out. Yeah, the Netflix Cuphead show is terrible. The animation is gorgeous, but the, like, writing is awful. It's so unfunny. Yeah, I don't know what they were thinking with the show, man. It's like, the game, gorgeous. Gorgeous animations and everything, but it's like, it's very action-y. They decided just not to do that with the show, I guess. I need to pull up a different reference so I can see the cape. No. Game cover will work. Just need to see a picture of the flippin' cape. Zoom. There we go. Oh my fucking god. Never mind. God damn it, I just need the cover of the game for reference on this cape, and nothing lets me zoom in. It's all going to, like, Walmart and stuff. Hold on. There we go. That's what I need. Okay. No, this part here below the vest is blue. There's a lot of red, and his hair is blue. His hair, I still gotta do the hair. And, like, the chin is, like, a blue. Thanks, Koku Draws. I have not drawn in a long time, so I'm really challenging myself today by doing a kind of a complex perspective and everything. Because, like, this is the top of, like, a flagpole. And the ground is down here. Or rather, it's, like, the top of a circus tent. So he, like, swizzled his way all the way up. And now he's, like, in the middle of a spin. So I'm trying to really pay attention to, like, the lines of motion. Yeah, it looks okay now, but once I get to inking, I'm sure it's gonna all fall apart. That's why I'm glad I'm streaming it, so that we have proof that I was doing okay at some point. Well, I'm gonna turn the music down a little. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it is just Balan or Balin or whatever. Actually, this is... Hold on, I wanna maintain line of motion with this, so... Yeah, there we go. I don't know, I could be wrong. I haven't played the game. I played the demo. It was okay. It feels very much like one of those games that you'd rent for the PS1 from, like, Blockbuster, play for one weekend and then be obsessed with forever, having only played, like, two levels, you know? Yeah, this cape. Let me think. It's about to twist this way. So the cape should be way out here. Still want it to be visible, though. No, wait. Gotta rethink how this fabric is moving. Yeah, like Bomberman Adventure. I remember getting that from, like, Blockbuster several times and never, like, getting very far in it. Like, Mischief Makers on the N64. That game was sick. Oh, wait, okay, this isn't just a detail in the sleeve. This is, like, the end of a glove, so I actually want to... I want to do this. Okay, I'm getting the curve wrong. Hold on, it's... There we go. That's closer. Still not quite there. gets a little wider up top. No, the other line was better. There we go. That's something. I'm still not happy with that, but that's, I'll leave that for now. It's not important for what I'm currently doing. Okay. In fact, this whole collar situation is incorrect, too. It's going the wrong direction for this line of motion. So it should actually be squished over here and then flowing out this way. Ruffle should go way out here. Something like that. I'm gonna work on that more in a minute. And then the cape actually, it's gonna be over here. Which actually I prefer because we have a lot more space to work with on this side. Okay. This would be the inside of the collar, which I presume is also gold and red. In fact, I believe that should go over the hand. Flapped open. Forget my line of motion. Let's go with one last big ruffle. way out there. Comes almost to a point. Yeah. Okay. See, it's spinning this way. So his cape is going to be furled around this way. Okay. Think. I think that should be even larger, actually. Hey, what am I doing? This is like a extreme perspective piece, so I should just go big and bold with it. Big, bold lines. Get this from another perspective to make sure I'm doing this cape correctly. I'm mostly getting same one picture. What's that look like? Oh, I see how it's shaped. Okay, hold on a second. So, yeah, we're still gonna go with this, but it's gotta come to a point over here. Comes to a point. In fact, that point will flare out a little bit. That comes to around here. That's that half. In fact, a little bit. I mean, it's not as nice a silhouette, but we're gonna. Is bigger and bolder, in fact. Okay. flashlight. Whoosh. Hold on. Not thinking of the entire shape of the thing. So it starts over here. Make sure this curve is correct for this shoulder. Okay. Let's make this even more extreme. Extreme, extreme, bold, bold, bold. That's all I need to remember. It's all super extreme. It's all super bold shapes. The style I'm going for is very big and crazy perspective. He's fucking 100 feet up. At least. Now I'm understanding, actually looking at this, what these are too. Those are like the bottom of shorts. Those are like little fluted tights. Which actually gives me an excuse. Once again, a little line of motion in there. In fact, this whole leg-foot situation, yeah, that's a little more, right? Yes. Okay. I understand the structure, this outfit a lot better now. See, so yeah, even though this shoe is technically still a solid object, it can still kind of bend in a way that matches with the line of motion that I've got going on, which is this sort of spiral. As the arm flips out that way, everything else gets dragged behind, everything's sort of squished or stretched. But the legs are still pretty much at this point. They started twirling like that going up, but when they got here, clamped down, so we still got a little bit pushed from when they stopped moving, so it went, so that's follow through, and then the rest is still untwirling, cartoon style. Okay, the cape was the next thing I was going to work on. Okay, cape just fully on this side, I think. In fact, we're just going to... Yeah, it would loop down here. Whole thing would actually come to down to the hips, so we can actually... Yeah, we're going big and bold, so this little notch in the cape will actually be way over here. A line that would lead over there. And then this whole area is just full of cape. So until I, you know, kind of colored in, it won't be quite as clear what's happening. So I'll just... in this piping. To kind of delineate it a little bit. But yeah, that's the whole cape just straight out. And in fact, I think I will make it a little more exaggerated once again. In fact, hold on, we're going from the shoulders out. No, actually, so it goes from the shoulder, it would go down to here usually, but we're going to like 90 degrees, so it goes out to here, then go over to here. The piping. Then we're gonna, yeah. Then this notch closer to here. Okay, there we go. Maybe a little bit. Yeah. That's the outer edge of the cape up there. Okay, hold on, it's... So the thing is, if I was doing this digitally, I could just kind of use multiple layers. I suppose I can just do that. This notch should be a lot more vertical, so actually we're gonna... And this too, actually, thinking about it, this should be... center. It comes to kind of a zenith right there. Then somewhere around here, which then goes up to here. Whoa. Okay. Yeah. It's a little more bulbous. Swoop. Or actually, it comes out like that, looks like. That's still quite a ways up the arm, actually. So. Okay. Way down at the bottom. I have the actual thing. This line should be much more extreme. In fact, let's make this a little shorter so I can put some little people down at the bottom to really emphasize the scale. No, no, no. This line should follow the line of motion. Because obviously, why do we have it if we're not going to use it in every possible way we can? Someone on stilts. I have like an old-timey motor car. See, even that's a little too big for that. So on and so forth. I'm not going to draw them all out right now.
Yeah.
What other details am I missing? It's like some kind of something. I'm not sure. Also looks like it's raised a little bit, so that'll come into play. Oh, and there's a little thing around each finger here. Let's see here. That's the only fingers you can really, well, I suppose you'd see it in this one. No, wrong way.